Hi, my name is Ella. I'm a student from Bristol, and for my Fixers project, I wanted to encourage more young people to get involved in politics and democracy in general. The Houses of Parliament contain both the House of Commons and House of Lords. The House of Commons is made up of MPs. MPs are elected to represent their constituency, and elections are held every 5 years. MPs are usually members of a political party, such as Labour, Liberal Democrats or Conservatives, but some MPs belong to no party and are known as independents. If one of these parties has a majority of MPs, they can form a government. Sometimes no party has an overall majority. This is known as a hung parliament. If this happens, the largest party usually tries to form a government with the support of another party or parties. This is known as a coalition government, like we had after the 2010 election. The government sits on one side of the House of Commons, and the opposition sit on the other side. The opposition MP's purpose is to question and criticise the government on behalf of the people they represent. The House of Lords are not elected. The majority are life peers who are appointed by the Queen on the advice of the Prime Minister, or on the advice of the House of Lords Appointments Commission. Other members inherit their title and are known as hereditary peers, and a limited number are bishops who represent the Church of England. New laws, also known as bills, or a change to an existing law, are presented for debate in both houses and must be approved by both in order to become law. The debates are chaired by the Speaker of the House. The Speaker decides if a vote is required on the bill and invites the MPs to express their opinions by saying aye or no to the motion. The Speaker will decide which side sounded more numerous and then say, I think the ayes or noes have it. If one side protests, then there has to be a proper vote called a division. In both Houses of Parliament, the members vote by walking through two corridors, known as division lobbies, and indicate whether the member is in favour or opposed to the motion. The Houses of Parliament are responsible for dealing with the big issues and making laws nationally, but local issues are taken care of by councils. County Council will be responsible for services across a whole county, such as education, transport, planning, social care, libraries and waste management. District or borough and city councils cover a smaller area and are in charge of rubbish collection, recycling, council tax collections, housing and planning applications. Each elected person on a council is known as a councillor and is in charge of a small area called a ward. You can find out who your councillor is online at www.writetothem.com. You can email or organise a meeting with them to raise any local issues you might have. Local councillors are elected by their local community for a term of 4 years. There are local council elections across England every year on the first Thursday in May. New councillors are elected where their four-year term has ended. Every council will publish online details of when key decisions will be taken, as well as papers and minutes of meetings. You can attend most council meetings if you wish. Although you probably won't be able to speak at them, it's a good chance to meet councillors and council officers. Many councils have a civic or Lord Mayor, who chairs council debates. Other councils have an elected mayor. They are responsible for the day-to-day running of local services. Some local authorities feel they aren't given enough money or power to be able to deal with local issues, which is why there is often discussion about central government transferring more power to them. This is known as devolution. The European Parliament is the directly elected representative institution of the European Union. There are currently 751 members of the European Parliament, representing constituencies from the 28 EU members. Their main job is to represent the interests of the people, cities and regions they have been elected to represent, and also to draft, make changes and vote on EU legislation. The European Parliament mainly works from Brussels and Strasbourg. The European Parliament has the power to make legislation in the UK, but it may need to be approved by the UK Parliament before coming into action. The UK joined the EU in 1973, and then a referendum was held 2 years later to decide whether the country wanted to stay part of it or not. A referendum is when citizens of a country, rather than a political representative, gets the chance to vote for a political decision, with a yes or no question, just like the Scottish independence referendum in 2014. There is often a lot of discussion about whether being in the EU is a good thing for the UK, because some people believe there are lots of benefits in working with neighbouring countries, such as trade and the freedom of movement. Other people don't like the fact decisions that impact our country are made elsewhere, with politicians from other nations. In order for our democracy to be fully functioning, it is crucial that everybody is aware that politicians work for us and are therefore answerable to us. I want everybody to be able to engage with politics and be empowered to fight for causes they believe in.